good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning, church family, friends, and loved ones. But most of all, happy Mother's Day! Woo! For it is Mother's Day, and there is no one like mothers. But then there's no one like our Father either. So we just want to thank you for tuning in. And we're going to ask you to not only tune in, but to turn up as we praise God. Because he's so worthy to be praised. Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Hallelujah.
Blessings and glory,
they are,
and all of
they are.
need it, God. So take everything. I don't want it. I don't need it, God. I just want you. I just want you. I just want you. Oh, I just want you. We just want you. We just want you. We just want you. Oh, we just want you. Take everything, Lord. Everything. I don't want it. I don't need it, God. Take everything. I don't want it.
I don't need it.
I just want
God.
You.
I just want you.
Hey. I just want you.
I just want you.
We just want you.
We just want you.
We just want you. We just want you.
We just want you.
Take everything, Lord. Everything. I don't want it. I don't need it, God. Take everything. I just want you.
I just want you.
Oh.
I just want you.
We just want you.
We just want you.
We just want you. We just want you. Oh. We just want you. We just want you.
We just want you.
We just want you.
We just want you.
We just want you.
We just want you.
We just want you. Everything, Lord, everything. I don't want it. I don't need it, God. Take everything. I don't want it. I don't need
it, God.
I just want you.
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 We 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 just want you.
Take me, I'm yours.
Ah. This morning's reading will come from Psalm 34, 1 through 3. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise will always be on my lips. I will boast in the Lord. The humble will hear and be glad. Proclaim the Lord's greatness with me. Let us exalt his name together. Let us pray. God, thank you this morning for all that you've done. Thank you, Lord, on this great Mother's Day. God, we thank you for giving us mothers and how they love us and care for us, Lord, and make sure all is well in our lives. We thank you this morning for your preached word. God, bless the man of the hour. Would you give him knowledge and wisdom, God, to pour out into a dying world? God, we pray for those that may be listening, Lord. Let a mind be changed. Let a heart be changed, Lord. And let us lead and live in this world the way that you've called us to. God, we pray for those that may be sick, those that may be shut in. All of us are actually shut in. And so, God, we thank you for keeping us during this season. Lord, we just want to continue to lift you up and honor you, whether times are good or bad. Lord, you still sit on the throne. And so, God, we love you. We honor you. We thank you for this platform that you've now given us, God, to share your gospel and the story of your son, Jesus. It is him that we love and we lift. Even now, in his name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, Greater Bethlehem, and all of our friends that are out there, wherever you're from. We're just excited that you've joined us today, and we say happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there, and a matter of fact, to all the women out there, because whether you are a mom biologically or whether you're a mom spiritually, then we honor you, or you sit in the role of a mom, because guess what? There are some dads out there, yeah, that you are holding it down in place of a mom, so whether you're in that role or however you're in that role, we welcome you today. And we are delighted that you're here to join us. We're going to have an awesome time today in the Lord. We're going to honor those who have gone before us, our moms, and we just have a wonderful service planned for you. You know, it's been said that in a world where so much is based on what we do, what you do may not be your greatest contribution into the kingdom. Your greatest contribution may be who you raised. So again, we welcome you and we're excited that you're going to be here. We bless you in Jesus' name. Just a couple things we want to remind you. Go ahead and hit that share button. We love for you to start a watch party so that others can join in and be blessed on today. I know you've already enjoyed the praise and worship, and yet is coming the word of God. So go ahead, take a minute. Hit that share button, let others know. And then, of course, if there are anything that we can do for you, if there's any need that you have, we want to serve you. So you're going to see the number up on the screen, but also you can grab a pen and jot it down. It's 972-638-9554. If any need that you have that we can serve you, then please give us a call, text us. We'd like to share with you. And then, of course, we'd like to see any moments of you worshiping today with your mom or with your family. So please feel free to grab your camera, grab your device, take a picture, and then hashtag us, hashtag the greater way. All right. Well, thank you so much. And we just look forward to, again, honoring you and blessing you today. We just pray God's blessings over you, not only today, but forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen. Welcome again. Thank you.
Well, good morning, family, GBBC, and the world. Hey, I'm Pastor Brown, and I'm here to just give you greetings with the joy of the Lord. We are celebrating our moms today. Moms, we love you so much. We have a little special tribute at the end of our service, and we're just grateful for every mom out there, every mom, every woman who has stood in the place for moms, and we give glory to God for you. We're in a series called Family Matters. And y'all, we've had a lot of fun. I praise God for our creative team that came up with that cool video. This is the fourth installment of our Family Matters series entitled Living Single. We've dealt with good times. We've dealt with golden girls. We've dealt with parents just don't understand. And now we're going to deal with singles. Not because they're lesser, but it's just the order that it came out. Amen, single folk. I get it. And so if you would meet me in the book of Philippians chapter 1. Philippians chapter 1. I want to draw your attention to verse 27, if you will. Verse 27, Philippians chapter 1. And we're going to read all the way through verse 30. I'm in the Christian Standard Bible. If you notice, somewhere in the chat line or anywhere around the post that you're in, you can click and get a digital version of our notes loaded directly to your device. So grab those real quickly so we can all be on the same page. Philippians chapter 1. Philippians chapter 1. Beginning at verse 27. As you turn, I praise God, y'all, for all the people behind the scenes. We're under 10, but I just praise God for the praise team, the musicians, AV, our staff. Listen, we're getting it done for the glory of God. Praise the Lord. All right, Philippians 1, gave you time to find it. Want to hear it? Here it goes. Just one thing. As citizens of heaven, live your life worthy of the gospel of Christ. Then whether I come and see you or am absent, I will hear about you, that you're standing firm in one spirit, in one accord, contending together for the faith of the gospel, not being frightened in any way by your opponents. This is a sign of destruction for them, but of your salvation, and this is from God. For it has been granted to you on Christ's behalf, not only to believe in him, but also to suffer for him. Since you are engaged in the same struggle that you saw I had and now hear that I have. Somebody say amen. That's a strong word. I want to talk from the topic living single, but on the flip side of that, experiencing community while in isolation. Experiencing community while in isolation. Let's pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and we glorify you for this moment. Father, you've met us here for a time of worship and for a time of fellowship, even digitally. Now I pray that you would allow us to be focused in on your word. Lord, the enemy wants to distract us and hold us back. And so I pray right now that you settle all of our spirits. Free us from the distraction of technology or personality. May we give it all to you, Lord. Our glory and our attention. In Christ's name we pray. Let everybody say amen. Come on, say amen. Give your neighbor an air five. Say amen. Praise God. Praise God. Living single. The big idea for today's message is simple. Here is what it says. Let's stand together. Let's stand together. There is not a show that captured the modern single living in the urban context like the hit TV show Living Single. In this show, you have two sets of roommates plus Max. And y'all, I loved Max. It was fun, it was funny, and it was trend-setting. But why? What made this show so engaging and so captivating? Perhaps the portrayal of every single one of them wanting to be both in community and in love. I don't want you to miss that. Every character in this series wanted to be both in community and in love. Could it have been that simple? But how about this? Can we take that simple desire that each of them shared for both community and for love, but add to its core a determination to glorify God? Oh, so when we add it all together, when we stack it all up, then singleness for the modern believer is the desire for community and for love, all while being determined to glorify God. Oh, guys, I like that by myself. See, that's powerful. That is so wonderful that every single individual that never been married, divorced, widowed, every single individual has a desire for community and for love. And as the followers of Christ that you are, we must place all of those desires upon the foundation of a commitment to glorify God with their single lives. Beloved, we exist to give God glory. And there is no greater response or responsibility than to live a life committed to God, committed to giving Him glory with everything that you are and everything that you do. So, single brothers and sisters, don't ever apologize for your desire to be married, to be in love, or for your desire to be in community. You have those desires because you are human, because you have been created in the very image of God, and our challenge is to place those desires under the authority and for the glory of God. Now, if you notice in my opening reading of the text, I did not choose or was not led, rather, to a passage on singleness, but to a passage on unity. A passage on community. Listen to the word of the Lord again. Just one thing in verse 27. As citizens of heaven, live your life worthy of the gospel of Christ. Then, whether I come and see you or am absent, I will hear about you that you're standing firm in one spirit, in one accord, contending for the faith of the gospel. Paul in this verse or these verses is in full exhortation mode. Paul says, I want to hear that you all are standing firm, that you all are standing together, that you all are unified in both physical and relational experiences, contending for the faith of the gospel. Here's the first movement of the text I want to highlight, and that is this. Single folks, live like you belong. Oh, I like that by myself. Live like you belong. The phrase, live your life worthy in verse 27, translates to sort of a political term. It meant a lot to the believers at Philippi, but check this out. It is translated, live as citizens. So to live worthy is to live as a citizen within the kingdom of God. Single believers. It is your life, but your life belongs to God. So you must live like God has papers on you. Y'all know about them papers, amen. When I was in high school, if a girl had, you know what I'm saying. So live like God has papers on you. The text says worthy. Meaning worth, meaning of value, suitable. Our lives are to demonstrate value. And understand this. When you look at all that the Lord Jesus Christ has done for you and for me, it is only fair that you will live a life that is sacrificed, that is set apart for His glory. Why? Because He alone is worthy. Single believers, because of your faith in Christ, you belong. Oh, let me say that again. Because of your faith in Christ, you belong. Now, I get it. The church hasn't done a good job of valuing your presence. We get a lot of things wrong in the church. At times, we've made it seem like something is wrong with you. Because you are not married, or we've pushed you aside from certain leadership opportunities because single people don't know nothing. That's kind of the mentality. But living like you belong is both spiritual and communal. Let me break this down. We belong to Christ, which dictates our day-to-day living for His glory. It dictates our willingness to be set apart for his glory. It dictates our willingness to grow through our mistakes rather than sulking in our sin. Y'all, that's the spiritual component. Because we belong to Christ, there is a spiritual component, but there's also a communal component. Living like you belong is communal. We are all a part of God's body, God's family, the church. So, beloved, you shouldn't be pushed out of service because you are not married. In the same way, you shouldn't push your church aside because of your overactive social life. I need a witness up in here. Belonging is both spiritual and communal. And in my research for today's message, I ran across an article, hope I can say this name right, written by Shannon Giannotti. Shannon Giannotti. It was entitled, Five Things Single People Need from the Church. Five Things Single People Need from the Church. It really helped me to see how, as pastor, I had missed the mark on certain things. Five things single people need from the church. This is extra. Don't count this my minutes from my sermon. Amen. I need this to be a little extra overtime. Here's the first thing she said that single people need. Number one, single people need the church to see us. And I'm speaking as if I'm single. To see us. And the specific language in this first movement is this. If you are a speaker or a presenter, talk about marriage, but also talk about the possibility of celibacy, watch this, and prolonged singleness. That blew me away because oftentimes when I preach and minister, I do not address the singles. First thing is seize us. Second thing, single folk need the church to validate us. Celebrate how God is using us by admiring our contributions or how we work to celebrate and glorify the Lord. And we validate them by understanding that they juggle more than the average individual. They have children. They're a single parent juggling all of these things to make sure that they're able to serve. Y'all, we have to intentionally validate. Seize us. Validate us. Thirdly, include us. Oh, I'm coming down your block, single folk. What the person said here is, mention the single folk when you pray. Something as simple as that. Include the singles in every aspect of your language, your verbiage, your prayers. And so the bottom line is this. When you are intentional to include the singles, you make sure that you have a single person at your house whenever you're having a fellowship. You make sure that you have a single person every time there is something you are doing that includes a part of our faith community. Include us. Next, help us. Oh, this is good, y'all. This is so good. First is seize us. Single people need the church to see us. Second, to validate us. Third, to include us. Fourth, to help us. Single moms out there are just going through. We need to have programs, men of Greater Bethlehem and beyond, where we help them with the things that we're good at. Making sure tires are properly inflated. Making sure windshield wipers are straight. Maybe there's some other things that we can do that would just help add value to their lives. Help us, the individual said. But then finally, welcome us into your family. Welcome us into your family. This is important, y'all. I gotta say this because this is for the wives. Wives, we cannot believe that every single woman is a threat to your marriage. And it's that sort of mentality that keeps us, watch this, from including the singles in our day-to-day activities as families. There is no reason why we shouldn't have single people in our faith community that are a part of our family. We got to welcome the singles into our families. Invite them to the football and baseball games. Invite them to the special award ceremonies. Welcome the singles into our family. So especially during the season of shelter in place, we need to do more for our single brothers and sisters to be intentional and to be inclusive, to meet them right where they are. Oh, the first thing we said about this message, I got a little off there, but that's good stuff, is to live like you belong, understanding that we belong both spiritually and communally. But the text is moving. Let's keep going. Not only must we live like you belong, single folk, but secondly, live to get along. Oh, I like that. Live to get along. Look at the 27th verse, the B clause. It says, then whether I come and see you or am absent, I will hear about you that you are standing firm in one spirit. Watch this. In one accord, contending together for the faith of the gospel, not being frightened in any way by your opponents. Listen to this, y'all. We have to live to get along. Text says, in one spirit, in one accord, contending together. But notice it says, without fear. Y'all, there are going to be some who come against us as believers. So Paul is suggesting that we got to stay close. Somebody say stay close. Come on, come on, say stay close, stay close, stay close. I can always remember when I found myself in certain situations where there was a threat against me bodily or elsewhere. And I'd be with my crew, if you will. And we'd always have this little mantra, just stay close. Because when you stay close, it's hard for attacks to come against you. The same thing in the spiritual realm. Y'all, we have to stay close. You got to live to get along. So community will never happen haphazardly. It won't happen haphazardly. We have to be intentional. Two things about that. Number one, we have to prioritize community. Oh, God, somebody say prioritize. Come on, say prioritize community. It has to be a priority. We have to put it high on our list. Greater Bethlehem, I'm coming down your block. This is why groups or tribes are so important. Because we have no idea how lonely people's lives can be. So Paul is suggesting if we're to be in one spirit, in one accord, contending together, we have to live to get along. We have to prioritize it. And this is where I know it's some spiritual warfare taking place, because the enemy does not want us to be in groups, to be held both encouragement and for accountability. This is why it's hard, but I'm not giving up, because we're going to prioritize community. But not only prioritize community, the text also says, fight our shared enemy. Oh, notice the last part of that. He says, contending together for the faith of the gospel, verse 28, A clause, not being frightened in any way by your opponents. Church, family, married, single folks, we all have a shared enemy, and we have to fight him collectively together. Yo, we got to stop fighting each other. We're not the enemy. Paul said, there's some opponents. And y'all, they're real. Oh, God, I've never been more clear. They are real, and they're seeking to destroy and discredit our faith. They're seeking to discredit the ministry that we're doing. And y'all, we have to fight this shared enemy. So we gotta be there for each other. The enemy is trying to destroy marriages, trying to compromise the quality of our single brothers and sisters' lives, trying to rob our children of their youth and innocence. Yo, we got to fight our shared enemy. What have I said thus far? I said in order for us to really experience living single, first thing we got to do is to live like you belong. Then secondly, we have to live to get along. I'm finished, y'all. Last movement of this text. Final movement is for us to live to go through. Oh, God, live. Live to go through. This faith walk ain't all glitz and glam. And I know I got some saints that have been walking with the Lord for a little while, and you can testify with me that walking with Jesus and hanging out with Jesus ain't always glitz and glam. Paul says in verse 29, "For it has been granted to you on Christ's behalf not only to believe in him, but also," watch this, "to suffer for him." The language of the text says we are granted not only to believe in, but to suffer for him. It is a privilege, y'all. We get to suffer for him. But remember, you belong to him, single folk, married folk, everybody. You belong to him. So it's a privilege to suffer for him. Let me stack this up. We are granted, privileged to both believe and to belong. Oh, God, I'm preaching up in here. I'm preaching to myself. It is a privilege to both believe and belong. And as you journey through your single lives, married folks too, when you stand for Christ, be prepared to suffer for Christ. Oh, God, when you stand up for righteousness, not behind a pulpit, but in your dating relationships. Oh, yeah, I got to go there before we dismount this. When you stand up for righteousness, single folk, in your dating relationships, on your jobs, in your community, when you stand up for righteousness, Paul has declared you will suffer. And he pulls no punches, y'all. And here's something I've said a million times. Well, maybe not a million, but a couple of hundred thousand. Here's what I've said. Many of us do not suffer for Christ because folks don't know we're Christian. So we haven't suffered because no one knows whose team we're on. We're so ambiguous. We're so ambivalent. We're so wishy-washy. We're so lukewarm. And beloved, I want to challenge you, single folks specifically, hear me. You cannot sin and win simultaneously. I'm testifying in just a moment, but you got to realize that you got to suffer for righteousness. You have to set your lives apart for his glory. That's when you know you're getting ready to suffer. I want you to experience all that God has for you, single folk. But if we continue living like those who don't know God, we'll miss out on the best parts of the faith, which is suffering. So as we press through to the end of this thought, Paul declares that there's going to come a day, oh glory to God, when every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. You're granted to confess with the world that Jesus is Lord. And beloved, I want you to do it now, and I want you to do it then. I want you to do it when you're dating and confess that my body is reserved for the Lord. And if you want this, you got to put a ring on it. I want you to confess loud and clear that my body is set apart for the glory of the Lord. So I'm not going to pollute my body with chemical substances beyond which I can handle. You're going to confess that Jesus is Lord. When that boss tries to get you to cheat on your taxes, on your job, you're going to say no and be willing to suffer for the glory of God. Be willing to suffer. So begin right where you are and begin living your confession of faith. Live the fact that Jesus is your Lord and leader. That's all I was going to confess, and I'm going to wrap this up with my confession. Both my wife and I came out of ungodly single lives. And those poor choices that we made led us to divorce. My wife said that she never believed that the Lord would ever give her a chance to love again. And I remember offering my letter of resignation to Dr. E.K. Bailey. Y'all, I call that heartbreak. Didn't know her, she didn't know me. Because of poor choices as singles, we made even worse choices. And it was at that point of heartbreak that the Lord got both of our attention individually. And by the grace and mercy of God, we found each other. Heartbreak led to healing. Let me tell you something, single folk. There are some things you don't have to experience to know that they dishonor God. You can look at some other folks' lives and say, you know what? I see how they chose to live and I see what that got them. I don't have to go down that path. Throughout this passage I've shared with you, Paul is dealing with living a life worthy of the gospel. So let's just make this plain. As singles, when we don't honor the Lord with our physical bodies, with our minds, when we make choices that go against His word, it will lead us to heartbreak. So my wife and I, we both heartbroken. She feeling she would never be loved. I'm feeling that my hopes for ministry were completely over. But yet we met at common ground and began healing. And one of the first things we declared to each other was that if the Lord gave us a chance to be a couple, then we do it God's way. Heartbreak led to healing, which led to holiness. And we made a declaration that we would set ourselves apart for the glory of God. And we honored the Lord throughout our courtship. And let's break this down. It was hard. But look at the byproduct. We're approaching 15 years of marriage. The Lord has blessed us with two beautiful children. And watch this. We rest well at night because we're guilt-free. Heartbreak led to healing, led us to holiness, and fourthly, it gave us hope. And I want to give that hope to you. My single brother and sister, you thinking, Pastor Brown, you don't know what I've done. You don't know how I've messed up. It really doesn't matter, because I serve a God of forgiveness. I serve a God of restoration. And watch this. You're looking at one who has been fully restored. So just allow me to pray for all the singles in the house. Just bow your heads right where you are. Father, in the name of Jesus, I lift up my single brothers and sisters. Thank you, Father, for this reminder in your word that you have created us for community. Father, help us in faith to live like we belong to you every moment of our lives. Help us, Lord, to let our light shine before men, not to put them under a bush, not to hide them, but to let them shine. And Father, as our light shine, may we give you glory. Help our lights to shine through our dating relationships. And Father, if we have become close to someone who has no desire to honor you, Father, help us to suffer and walk away. Help us to suffer that pain for your glory. Father, if we're involved in things that simply contradict your word, give us the courage to pursue holiness. And then, Father, help us to live to get along. Father, I pray that the singles would come out and to be a part of our faith community, to help us as the church to do our part, to see them, to welcome them, to acknowledge them. And then, Father, help us to live, to go through. Lord, we got to suffer. We got to go through some stuff. We love you, Father. We thank you. We pray coverings over all of our singles. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Come on, give God a little praise. Come on, give a little praise right where you are. Come on, hallelujah, hallelujah. Singles, we love you. We love you. We love you so much. Holler at your boy. Throw some comments in there. Just let me know how this message spoke to you. And we're going to have a follow-up on Wednesday. We can further engage. Now, I want to take some time now because I don't want this to be taken lightly. But you're listening. You probably heard the whole sermon or maybe just the last few moments. And you've heard me talk about the glory of Christ and the gospel and all that goes along with that. And I want to give you a chance right now to make a profession of faith. I want to give you a chance right now to receive a free gift. Here it is. God loves you, has a wonderful plan for your life. But we can't know and experience that because of our own sinfulness. That simply means this, y'all. We were born with our backs turned toward God, going in the opposite direction. That's what sin does. But third, I want you to know that Jesus Christ is God's only provision for our sins. Jesus came to earth. He lived, he served, and he suffered a sacrificial death for you and for me. Through his death, he paid the price for our sin. And all you got to do is receive that gift, receive all that he did, that finished work on the cross called Calvary, where he died. Individually, make that decision. And here's what's all involved. Lord, I need you. Thank you for dying on the cross for my sins. I open up the door of my heart and I receive you as my Savior and Lord. Come into my life. Make me the kind of person you want me to be. If that even speaks remotely to where you are, I'm going to pray it one more again. And I want you to just repeat it after me. Father, God, I need you. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for dying on the cross for my sins. I open up the door of my heart and I receive you as my Savior and Lord. Come into my heart and make me the kind of person you want me to be. According to your word, I am now saved. In the name of Jesus, amen. Now, if you made that prayer, that profession of faith, y'all, shoot us a text message, please. We want to follow up with you. We're not going to bombard you with anything. We just want to see you and get to know you and hang out with you if you allow us to. But shoot us a text message, 972-638-9554, 972-638-9554. Well, guess what? Guess what, y'all? It's time for the offering. Somebody say, yeah. Say, yeah. Hey, I get excited when it's time to give because that lets me know that my worship is not complete until I've made a sacrifice. So it's a privilege we are granted the privilege to give. I want you to give in a way that glorifies God. There are four ways on the screen now. You'll see how to give. You can go to greaterdallas.org/give and you can text to give. You can drop it off or we'll come pick it up. Let me pray. Father, we thank you for this opportunity to give. May it give you glory as we give to you. In Christ's name, amen. One more time, it's time for the offering. Say yeah! All righty. And now our announcements.
Happy Mother's Day. Great day, GBBC. You are listening to The Greater Way, and here are your Mother's Day announcements. The Farm Stand is accepting pre-orders. Please use the order form in the weekly email newsletter. The order deadline is Wednesdays at 5 p.m. Text 214-240-8423 for more information. GBBC ambassadors, please stay diligent in sharing information and checking on others, especially our Silver Stars. You can always connect with your church. Text 972-638-9554 or email info@greaterdallas.org, or you can leave a voicemail at 214-388-7979. We are your church. Join us Sundays at 10:15 a.m. for worship and Wednesday evenings at 7:15 p.m. for Bible study. Connect through Greater Dallas Facebook Live, Greater Dallas YouTube live stream, or call 972-486-9929. Join us Tuesdays and Thursdays at 12:15 p.m. for the weekly check-ins and Wednesday at 6:30 a.m. for the prayer call. Dial 319-527-4229. Log in Thursdays at 7 p.m. for the Zoom video conference. And please see the email newsletter or Greater Dallas Facebook group for invite information. Please check the website, emails, and Facebook groups for updates and additional information. We would like to wish all members born in the mighty month of May a very, very happy birthday to you. And we would also like to wish all the mothers, grandmothers, aunties, godmothers, and everything in between a very happy and blessed Mother's Day. You have yourself a phenomenally blessed week, and you've been listening to The Greater Way.
Hey, it is Mother's Day. Listen. Now, I don't want y'all going out. Don't do that buffet this time. No, don't do the buffet. Don't do the buffet. Listen, Uber Eats, call, have something delivered, and they're going to have on gloves and a mask, but y'all stay home in the name of Jesus. But mothers, we love you so much. And here is just a little snippet of some of the videos and pictures that we receive just to demonstrate, Mom, the love that we have for you. You're so special. Check this out.
Happy Mother's Day, Greater Bethlehem Baptist Church, from our family to yours.
On this very special Mother's Day, we want to just send you all the love in the world. And this little video here is going to capture some of the greetings we received this week. God bless. Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day to my mother, Phyllis Shackelford, because she did, I am, and I can. I love you, Phyllis Shackelford. Happy Mother's Day.
Hi, this is Noah Fields. I would like to pay a tribute to my grandmother for Mother's Day. She has been a great mother to this family. She has been a great leader to this family. We love her dearly. She works so hard so all of us can have it. Thank you so much.
I want to take this time to wish my mom, Gloria D. Martin, a very happy Mother's Day. Darling, we love you. Say, we love you.
We love you, darling.
Happy Mother's Day to my mom, Mrs. Patricia Ann Ward. Thank you for your consistent, wise advice. Thank you for your friendship, and thank you for loving me unconditionally. Love you, and today is all about you.
I'm striving every day to be as wonderful as you are. I love you, Mama. Happy Mother's Day.
We salute you, Patricia Ward. Happy Mother's Day. We thank you for everything that you've done, the things that you will continue to do in our lives. We love you. We honor you on this day.
To my mom, Sandra Harris, thank you for your unconditional love throughout the years. I am definitely the woman I am today because of you. Happy Mother's Day, Mom. Love you.
My mom, Dr. Bobby Lowe, a happy, happy Mother's Day. We love you so much.
We love you.
Happy Mother's Day.
All right, moms, we love you. We love you so much. And we're ready to go. We're ready to go. But remember, GBBC, we have so many opportunities to stay connected. Let's not lose this. We're trying to create some digital groups so that we can have what Paul talked about in this passage, standing side by side, contending for the gospel. So look for some of that in our email blast. If you are not a part of our email blast, just shoot me a direct message. Hey, I'm getting more proficient on Facebook. Shoot me a direct message. I'll make sure that you get on our email database. That's it. I think we're ready to go. Let's all stand. Come on, you can stand at home. Come on, stand up. We're going to get this benediction. Come on, stand. Mothers, again, we love you. Remember, we're not doing anything on campus. We're not going to even begin the discussions until June. We're making plans now, but we're not going to even begin the information disbursement until June. So just relax yourselves. We're going to finish May, and then we're going to see what June has to offer. Let's pray together. Father, we love you. We thank you. We give you glory. For our singles, thank you for what they mean to us, because we know what they mean to you. Help them, Father God, to trust you in every area of their lives. And Father God, may you bless them as they grow in their singleness. We say, may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, love of God, communion of the Holy Spirit be with each of us until we meet again. Then everybody say, amen. God bless you. We'll see you Wednesday night for Bible study, 7:15. Hey, I may go live. Take care.
It's a great, great God who is worthy to be.